Hello dear students, I'm Dr. Neha Taneja, and as promised, I've come up with a video today on sampling. Basically, I'll be trying to discuss this video in two parts. Before we go into sampling, two important terms here that you should understand. One is what is a population and the other is what is a sample. So what is a population? Population is simply, a larger group or the study elements that we are interested at a particular time to find something about. Okay? So you could say these are larger group, okay, or study elements, okay, that we are interested at a particular point of time. Okay, on whom we want to find out something about that larger group. Now, group bahut large hai. So, if we conduct our study on such a large group, it will involve a lot of time, a lot of resources, a lot of money, manpower, everything. So, what do we do? From this population, we take, from this large population, we take a smaller part of it. Okay? That smaller part of that bigger population is what is known as sample. Okay, so this is a smaller part of the bigger population. But please remember, this sample that we've taken, suppose this is our bigger population, we take a small part of it to study. But this small part is a representative of this, has to be an accurate and a correct representative of the bigger part, okay, of the bigger population. So this sample is what? It is a, I'll use a different color, it is a representative of the larger population. What do I mean by this? That this sample is a representative of the larger population. It means that although we will be doing our study on this sample, okay, so study will be done on this sample, but the results will be interpreted for, or the results will be extrapolated to the entire population. Okay, in other words, statistically, agar hum likhe, to the statistical inference, okay, will be applied to the bigger population, jiska ye sample hissa hai, theek hai? To the bigger population. Please remember this. These are two very important terms before we try to understand the techniques of sampling. Population is the larger group. Ho sakta hai 10,000 slum dwellers ho, 10,000 migrants ho, sab mein study nahi kar pa sakte hai. Okay, abhi suppose in the times of COVID-19, we want to study the behavior pattern, risk assessment, something. So, we'll take a small sample of them. We'll take say 100, 150. Again, abhi I'm just saying that we can take 500, 600, 120. Uska bhi procedure hai to calculate how much of a sample is exactly needed to do my study. That we'll be discussing when we talk about sample size calculation. Abhi just think that hum sample lete hai 100 logo ka ya 150 people ka. So, we will be doing our study on that sample, which is the accurate representative of that bigger population, and the results that we get will be extrapolated or will be applied to this larger population. Now let's come to sampling technique. Sampling technique do hai, which is very important. One is the random sampling, okay, random sampling, and the other is the non-random sampling. Now first try to understand this word random. Okay, random generally it means that it is not organized, it is not something which is not disciplined, aise waise karke kuch, theek hai? But when we talk about sampling, random here means something that's happening in a very, you know, something that's happening in a very organized manner. दैट इज रैंडम मीनिंग हियर. सो सैम्पलिंग में रैंडम का मतलब क्या होता है कि देखो यू आर ट्राइंग टू टेक आउट और यू आर ट्राइंग टू सिलेक्ट अ स्मॉल सैम्पल फ्रॉम द एंटायर पॉपुलेशन. सो इफ द पॉपुलेशन हैज 10,000 पीपल, ओके, से 10,000 रिप्रोडक्टिव एज फीमेल्स, you have to give each and every participant or each and every person of that population of that reproductive age group an equal chance and a known chance to be included in the sample. That is the meaning of random here. theek hai, random means that everybody in the population gets an equal and known chance, theek hai, known chance of being included in the sample. This is the meaning of random, equal and known. Guys, this comes as an MCQ also. They'll ask random in random sampling means equal and known chance, unequal and unknown chance, known but unequal chance, something like this. So it simply means that everybody in the population gets an equal chance and known chance. हमें पता होना चाहिए कि 1/100 chance हर पर्सन का है. ओके, सपोज वी ड्रॉ अ सैंपल ऑफ 100 फ्रॉम द 10,000, देन एवरीबडी शुड हैव 1/100 चांस ऑफ बीइंग इंक्लूडेड इन दैट सैंपल. ओके, सो ऑफ बीइंग इंक्लूडेड इन द सैंपल. नॉन रैंडम इज नथिंग लाइक दैट. इट्स नॉट, इट्स वी डू नॉट वरी अबाउट whether everybody is getting a chance of being included in the sample or not. So the problem of bias and so many things arises. By this we are eliminating the problem of bias also. ठीक है, सो नॉन रैंडम सैम्पलिंग. देर आर सर्टन अदर टर्म्स टू डिफाइन इट. रैंडम सैम्पलिंग द अदर वर्ड इज ऑल्सो प्रोबेबिलिटी सैम्पलिंग. ओके, एंड फॉर नॉन रैंडम सैम्पलिंग इट इज नॉन प्रोबेबिलिटी सैम्पलिंग. ओके, नॉन प्रोबेबिलिटी सैम्पलिंग मीन्स, सो इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज प्रोबेबिलिटी एंड हियर नॉन प्रोबेबिलिटी. प्रोबेबिलिटी बिकॉज एवरीबडी हैज अ नोन एंड इक्वल चांस, अ प्रोबेबल चांस फ्रॉम द पॉपुलेशन टू बी इंक्लूडेड इन द सैम्पल. इट्स नॉट हियर, इट्स नॉट द केस विद नॉन रैंडम सैम्पलिंग. अदर वर्ड फॉर दिस इज नॉन पर्पसिव. ओके, बट इफ यू टॉक अबाउट नॉन रैंडम सैम्पलिंग इट इज अ पर्पसिव सैम्पलिंग. वाई? बिकॉज इन नॉन रैंडम we are purposely including people who are easily accessible to us. Okay, suppose I have to do a study in college students, jitne mujhe canteen mein mil gaye maine unko le liya. theek hai, so I am making it purposefully easy for me. Okay, this is non purposive. Here we have to select them by a technique so that everybody has an equal and known chance. So this is basically the terminology that describe random sampling and non random sampling. Let us look at some of the techniques that you need to know for random and non-random sampling. For random sampling, we have simple random sampling, we have systematic random sampling, we have stratified random sampling, multi-stage, multi-phase and cluster sampling. These are the most important sampling techniques out of random sampling that you need to know. Non-random mein hota hai convenience, snowball, quota, purposes samplings. MCQs कैसे आते हैं? They can ask you the following is a random sampling technique. All of the following are non-random sampling technique except. Okay, or they would give you some example and they would say this this is how people were selected, which type of sampling technique it is. So we need to understand them one by one to get a clear picture and to be able to answer the questions. Let's try to understand the first technique of random sampling, which is simple random sampling. Now, as the name suggests, it's very simple. Let us try to understand what is simple random sampling. Now, suppose ek Anganwadi center hai, wahan pe there are 100 kids. Okay? Now, what we have to do? We have to find out the average weight of, say, the sample is, we have to find the average weight of, say, these 100 kids. Okay, average weight of 100 kids. We need to find out. Now, weighing each one of them, and they're all up to 2 years. Okay, now weighing each one of them will take time. So, we have decided that we will take a sample of 10 children. Okay? Now, what happens that all of them are sitting like this in a row. Pehle row mein there are 10 children. Second row mein there are 10. Like this, like this, like this, like this. How are they sitting? आंगनवाड़ी सेंटर में उन्होंने अपने बच्चों को कैसे बताया? लाइक इन द फर्स्ट रो आर चिल्ड्रन हु आर से थिन बिल्ट. ठीक है, सम सेकेंड रो में मीडियम बिल्ट है. ऐसे करके दे हैव क्लासिफाइड देम, दे हैव मेड देम सिट in 10 rows. Now suppose I pick up all these 10 students or 10 children from the first row. Then what will happen? I will get the average weight on the lower side because on the first row all thin built children were sitting. Okay, man, the first 4 rows are for all thin built children. Okay, next 2 rows are for medium built children and last 12 rows are heavy built children. So agar maine last 2 rows le liye ya maine beech ke le liye, so my my average weight will not be correct representative of these 100 children. Okay, so what I do, I adopt a method. Okay, what is that method? It is known as lottery method. Isme kya hota hai lottery method mein? Isme kya hota hai ki ye there are 100 kids. Okay, each of them is assigned a number. So suppose this first one is given number 1, second one is 2, 3, 4, like this. So everybody is assigned a number. You put them in a bowl. So this bowl has 100 chits. All these 100 children are assigned a number. Now I start picking up a chit. So what is happening when I'm picking up a chit? I'm giving each of these 100 children an equal chance of being included in my sample. So this is what is known as simple random sampling by lottery method. Why is it random? Because main chit utha rahi hu and each chit has a child. Okay, each chit is representative of this entire population. Maine is pure population mein 100 bachche hain, sabko ek ek number assign kar diya. Okay, so simple random sampling ye hai and this method is known as lottery method. Okay, there are other methods for simple random sampling. Ek hota hai table of random numbers. Okay, isme kya aata hai table of random numbers mein, that it's just a booklet. Okay, and I'll just show you that booklet is assigned numbers. Numbers like suppose 001, 012, 035, or if this number is suppose present 100 times in that booklet, then this will also be present 100 times in that booklet. Okay, so by randomly, by lottery or by anything, you just randomly pick one number. Then you can start proceeding in a horizontal direction or in a vertical direction to select my other participants. Okay, so suppose my population is 10,000 and I have to select 500 people from it. Okay, sample of 500. So there's one table of random numbers I take. So the first number that I pick is say 120. तो 120 देखो यहाँ पे क्या है एंड स्टार्ट फॉलोइंग वर्टिकली और हॉरिजॉन्टल एंड स्टार्ट पिक अप योर चिल्ड्रन टिल यू रीच टू द सैंपल ऑफ 500. नाउ सपोज दिस नंबर द फर्स्ट वन दैट यू पिक अप कम्स 640. नाउ 640 इज व्हाट? 640 इज मोर देन 500. ठीक है, सो आई विल हैव टू सब्सट्रैक्ट 500 फ्रॉम दिस. ओके, 6 - 5 = 1. सो द माय फर्स्ट नंबर विल बी 140 दैट आई नीड टू पिक अप. One more method, which is software based methods. The computer keeps on generating random numbers, and also there is one method, currency method. Currency method mein kya hota hai? Currency notes hote hain that are numbered from 1 to 100, and you keep if you start drawing them randomly. Pehla number aaya 23 currency note ka, so you pick up the 23rd child allotted that number. Okay, so these are methods of simple random sampling: lottery method, table of random numbers, software method and currency method. The best out of this is table of random numbers. Now what are the points from this simple random sampling that you need to remember? It is simple, easy, but you need to have a list of the entire population present with you. If you do not have this, you cannot pick up people. ठीक है, now suppose what happens by chance, क्या होता है जब मैं चिट्स उठा रही थी, I still end up including these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, all the children from the first row only in my sample. By chance it happens. Now what to do? That is where comes the use of systematic random sampling, which we'll try and understand in the next lecture. Today remember simple random sampling ke baare mein we studied about population kya hai, sample kya hai, different types of names for the random samplings and the techniques of random, non-random sampling and simple random sampling.